Welcome everybody. Today we are on episode 2 of our Beginner's Guide to Embroidery. We are going to be talking about stabilizers. Hey everybody, Tricia here with Sewing Parts Online. Before we begin, if you could take a moment to like and subscribe, that way you'll get notified of any future video that we have. We recently released our first video in our Beginner's Guide to Embroidery. That episode was on choosing a machine. So if you haven't seen that one yet, be sure to check it out at the end of this video. Let's get right into talking about these stabilizers. The first thing that I want to clarify is you may have heard a couple of different terms, stabilizer as well as interfacing. Interfacing is meant to be permanently added to the fabric, kind of like for a collar or maybe using it for buttonholes, whereas a stabilizer generally is removed after you've done your stitching. I like to think of stabilizer as a foundation for your stitches. When beginning embroidering, stabilizers were probably the most confusing thing to me. There's a lot of different types, there's a lot of information out there, and there's a lot of different opinions. You think to yourself, when do I use it? How many layers should I use? What type of fabric is it for? Hopefully with this series, I'll be able to answer some of those questions for you. So let's take a look at the packaging. On each package, it's going to tell you the type, the weight, and how it's applied. So for an example, when it comes to the type, you've got a cutaway, a tearaway, a washaway, and a heataway. So this one says cutaway. And that's exactly what you're going to do. You would take a scissors and you would cut the product away after you've done your stitches. A little saying that I like is, if you wear it, don't tear it. So if you're going to be putting it on clothing, a good option is using the cutaway. If it was a tearaway, you would be doing exactly what it says on that as well. You would simply tear the stabilizer away. And you guessed it, with wash away, it's going to use water. And with heat away, you would use an iron. Once you apply the heat, it'll just brush away. Let's talk a little bit about each type. I found this great sampler pack, and there's something to be said for being able to actually see and feel a product. This particular one includes 19 different examples, and I found it so helpful to be able to touch it. Another benefit is it gives you information regarding each one, like when they're useful. So if you're looking at the cutaway stabilizers, it specifically tells you that it's a permanent stabilizer. It eliminates pulled or sagging stitches. It's excellent for stretch resistance. So cutaway is ideal when using knits. It also states that it's reliable and that it remains with the fabric for continued stabilization through laundering and washing. So that's really nice to have all those details. Now, moving on to the tearaway, it states that it's a temporary stabilizer. It easily tears away for removal, prevents stitch distortion. It's versatile because you can use one or more layers if needed. Tearaway is great with woven fabric. Next, you've got your washaway option. That also is a temporary stabilizer. It's going to remove with water. And this little tip is great. It's wonderful if you do not want any stabilizer showing on either the front or the back. So in that circumstance, you would use a wash away. And not to forget about the heat away. That one is going to be a temporary stabilizer as well. Easily brushes off after heat is applied. And it's perfect to use when wetting or tearing is going to distort the fabric in the stitches. We have another great video on stabilizers, so I will be sure to include a link for that video at the end of this video. It's always good to have more information. Now that we've talked about the type, let's talk about the weight. On each package, you're going to see either light, medium, or heavy. In this area, I did find a lot of conflicting information. Some opinions stated that if you have light fabric, use light stabilizer. They were saying match the weight of your stabilizer with the weight of your fabric. Other information was stating if you're using light fabric, use heavy stabilizer to give it a little more body. Or if you're using heavy fabric, use light stabilizer since you wouldn't need much stabilization. All of it makes sense, so it made me pause. I was like, what's the right way to do it? And then I remembered something. I had taken a class on stabilizer, and this gentleman who's been doing embroidery for many, many years pointed out that everybody does it differently. He pointed out three of his coworkers, and they were discussing one similar project, and they all did it differently. So at that time, I kind of was like, nope, red flag. That's making me twitch. I want to know the fabric type, what stabilizer to use, when to use it. And I was like, maybe embroidery is not for me. But then he encouraged everybody that it just takes time and practice and finding what works well for you and your machine. And also, people learn what brand they prefer and methods that they like. And he just encouraged everybody to get in there and do it. Once he told me that, I took a breath and dove right in. So we've covered the type and the weight. Now we just need to talk about how it's applied. So the packaging is going to show you that as well. You'll see like an iron, if it's going to be an iron-on. This particular one shows that it's a self-adhesive, so it's going to have a sticky back. Others don't have either of those, and you could either baste it in or use an adhesive spray. A lot of people will do what's called floating, where you've got your stabilizer down and then you use an adhesive spray and place the fabric on top without hooping the fabric. We'll discuss that more in our upcoming episode on hooping. I want to take a quick moment to talk about this product. It's called Terial Magic. It is a spray-on stabilizer. So just a quick overview. You saturate the fabric and then you let it dry kind of to a damp consistency, and then you iron it and your fabric turns into like a paper-like feel. It is incredible. Then you don't have to use a stabilizer with your fabric. It's already stabilized. It's pretty cool. You have to see it in person to appreciate it. I hope that you are able to take a little something from this video. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask. Please comment below and I will do my best to answer them. Make sure to keep an eye out for our next video in our Beginner's Guide to Embroidery series. It's going to be about needles. Thank you so much for joining me. Until next time.